Everyone, so this will just be a short intro into lists, which are a very important part of statistics, and we do a lot with them. So the first thing that we'll do is put some values into a list. We're going to press stat. We are then going to press enter because we want to go to number one, which is edit. And now we see all of our lists, and you can see that the default here on my program is 6 lists, although you can actually get more. So we'll go to list number one, and then what you want to do is just put in whatever your values are, and I'll just put in some random values here. Doesn't matter what you put in or how many, but I'll put in 10 values. So notice these values range from small to large, and within the list, they go big, small, back to big, small. So now our values are in the list. Every time I put in a number, I just press enter, and that takes me down to the next line in the list. So what I want to do is sort this data. So I'm going to go back to stat. I am then going to press either number 2, or I'm going to scroll down and then press enter. So sort A means sort ascending, which means ascending is from smallest to largest. So I press sort A. Then I'm going to put in which list I want to sort. So notice on the keypad, number 1, right above it, it says L1, and that's what we want. We want list number 1. So we're going to press second and then L1. And what that does, of course, is tells the calculator to sort list 1. We put the parentheses to close it up, not actually necessary, but you can. And then I press enter. And now it just tells me I did it. Calculator has sorted the data. So now when I go to stat and back to edit, so enter again, notice that the data is now in order. Notice as well that down at the bottom, it tells us which data value we are in. So list 1, number 1 is a value of 2. List number 1, value 2 is a 2. List number 1, value 3 is a 6. So it tells you where you are in the list as well. And now your data is sorted. Very easy to find whichever data value you need for some of the different functions we use in the class. If I would like to clear that data, so I don't want those data values in a list anymore, I'm going to go back up. I'm going to scroll up to the top using my arrows so that I'm on list number 1, whichever list I want to clear. And then I'm going to press clear. Then I'm going to press enter. Notice all the values are now gone. Great. Now, the only other thing I want to show you in this video is what would happen if you deleted a list. So every once in a while, a student, instead of pressing clear, will press delete. Notice list number 1 now gone when I press delete. That's a problem. It's just one less list that you have. And so in order to get that back, all you need to do is press stat, go down to setup editor, and then just press enter. And now it says done. And what that's done, if you now go back to stat and number 1 for edit, you're going to see that list come back. So you want to use clear if you want to clear your list of the data values. Don't use delete, but if you do, just a couple steps to get your list back.